morning to all of you guys, gals, and non-binary pals. It is your host, Athena Sarmiento, and welcome back to another show of Whitney High Live. So, just a quick reminder before we start this broadcast, it is homecoming time. So, if you are a senior, please go to whitney.votingforschools.com. Your username and password should both be your 6-digit ID number. Voting ends at 10:15 a.m. And once you vote, the top 10 nominees will be revealed through Instagram and YouTube this Friday, May 7th. Now, kickstarting our show today, we have an amazing collab with ASB, Beyond the Books, and All Us about a book drive. Check it out.
Hey Whitney, as most of you know, Beyond the Books does a book drive every year in order to give back to youth shelters or elementary schools. This year, the pandemic has made it harder for us to conduct events like these and collect these items. However, we are still determined and willing to give back to those in need.
This year, Beyond the Books, ALAS, and ASB are going to be teaming up to collect books for the migrant children currently being housed at the Long Beach Convention Center.
These children are temporarily living at the Long Beach Convention Center while they wait to be reunited with their families from across the border. They have access to school materials, social workers, and activities such as video games and outdoor sports. We want to collect as many books in English and Spanish for them to read and enjoy.
We will be collecting books from Monday, May 10th to Friday the 14th in the front office. You'll find one box for the books in English and one for books in Spanish.
We have created a list of recommended books as well as places to get them, which you can find on the Whitney website under Student Council. You can also donate your own old books as we usually do.
Thanks for listening, Wildcats, and we hope you're able to help us make a difference.
And just in time for Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month, we have Club Kai Vegan showing us their PCN Rewind. Here it is.
One thing I miss about PCN is everyone being together.
Is yelling out our chant.
It's Hell Week.
The spontaneous get-togethers.
Being able to hang out with my friends.
Performing on stage.
I'm a couple hundred miles from Japan and I was thinking I could fly to your hotel tonight. Cause I can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Did you got plans tonight? I was hoping I could get lost in your paradise. The only thing I'm thinking about is you and I. Cause I can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. I can't seem to get you off my mind.
So the month of May is very stressful for a couple of reasons, but mainly because of APs coming around the corner. So why don't we all just take a second to relax while we listen to Vianney's Merry Minute.
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Vianney Marie's Merry Minute, where I tell you some good news in under a minute. Let's get started! First, I have a story about a new reef-safe sunscreen that has been developed by British researchers. Most sunscreens contain chemical materials that are damaging to the environment or zinc oxide that is produced in an expensive or harmful way. This research team from the University of Sheffield and Imperial College London has discovered a more sustainable way to produce the zinc oxide particles. They made a company called Nanomox in order to produce the sunscreen and sell in the future. Next, we have a story about the oldest known wild bird who had recently hatched another chick. Wisdom, a 70-year-old Laysan albatross, has returned to the Midway Atoll National Wildlife Refuge to hatch her chick. This refuge is managed by the U.S. Department of Commerce, Department of Interior, and the state of Hawaii, and helps many species of birds each year. Lastly, we have a story about a new laundry detergent created by Unilever that is made of industrial carbon emissions. Unilever, as well as Lanza Tech and India Glycols, use biotechnologies to create this new cleaning product, from recycled carbon to eliminate the use of fossil fuels. This is a part of Unilever's home care division's plan to net zero emissions. And that's some good news we have this week. See you on the next episode of Merry Minute. Bye!
So I know that everyone might be wanting a vacation right now during this stressful month, and trust me, I get it. So in the meantime, we can watch Athena's Las Vegas hotel food review with some people that you might recognize. What's up, Wildcats? It's Athena Sarmiento here, and today I'm in Las Vegas with...
Christian?
Yo, run that back.
What's up, Wildcats? It's Athena Sarmiento here, and I'm here with...
Austin.
And Christiana.
So.
So today, I'm in Las Vegas with my cousins and we're visiting the Delano Hotel. And today we are going to review some hotel food for you guys.
Got some barbecue glazed chicken tenders with seasoned fries, Cajun style, with some little veggies on the underneath. We're about to try this. Dink it.
Okay, ready? Oh, it's crunchy.
Wait, ASMR. I got nails, hold on.
No food.
It's really dry.
Okay, Gordon Ramsay.
It's lacking moisture.
I get that.
Fries are solid. Solid 4.
I think the fries are good, yeah.
Mm-hmm. They're not soggy.
So, chicken tendies, I give 3. Fries, I give 4.
Mm-hmm. 3 or 4?
3 or 4.
I say like chicken tenders, 3. Fries, 3.5.
They're
pretty good. So here we have a chicken quesadilla with some sour cream, and they also gave us salsa.
You ready?
Mm-hmm. Thanks.
I don't like the chicken.
I don't know if it's because we waited too long or is like the cheese cold.
Oh, I'm not even worried about that.
I can make this at home.
Yeah.
Seasoning.
Look.
This is not worth $38.
Mappa? You could do better than this.
No, but look, the chicken is like no seasoning on it.
It's dry.
It's just gray.
2 out of 5. Not even a 2, 1. 0.
You're generous.
0.
0 out of 5? Not even a 1?
Chicken is dry, cheese is cold. I can make it at home. And look, this is even falling apart. Look, see? It's not even done properly, bro. It's not even hot.
I feel like it's edible, though. So I'm gonna give it just a 1.
I'll give it a 1.
Mm.
Could be better.
Could be better. Too much better. Okay, so the last food that we have is some pepperoni pizza. Obviously, it looks kind of greasy, but we'll see how it turns out.
Okay, presentation-wise, not the best.
You know, it could be better.
One slice doesn't even have a pepperoni on it.
But it is the corner piece.
That's true.
Why is it a square?
Yeah, they cut it into squares.
Why is it a
first bite?
First bite?
First bite. I'll take this corner
We'll take
piece.
The no pepperoni one.
Yeah,
you take the biggest one.
Oh, look at that.
It fell off so easily.
The cheese fell off.
Dock points.
That's a couple stars off right there.
Okay, ready?
You know what it reminds me of? Like the pizza they gave you in like elementary school.
Mm.
The crust is very crunchy. Like, listen.
True. I think it's better than the quesadilla.
It's better than the quesadilla, but it's not better than the chicken tenders, for sure.
So what does that deserve? Like a 2?
I'll give it a 2 out of 5.
I'll give it a 2.5. Alright, y'all.
So that is all that we have for the video today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a great day, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye! And last but not least, with COVID vaccines being handed out left and right, we have some of LA's guidelines for COVID this year, so make sure to check it out.
With the reopening of our schools statewide for kindergartners through high schoolers, I felt that it would be necessary to give a bit of background information about LA's school reopening guidelines. So I decided to scour the LA Department of Public Health's protocols, and here is what I found. According to the LA Department of Health, cohort size should be as small as possible, and the recommended distance between people should be 6 feet, but the minimum should be 3. The maximum cohort size is based on the space available, but there can only be 30 people per cohort, regardless of the size of the available program space. The guidelines here are sort of the same as the PSAT, ACT, SAT, and AP testing. However, all of the students and teachers have to be spaced at least 6 feet apart, and no more than 30 students maximum can be grouped together in the testing space. And of course, everyone has to wear masks, etc., etc. On campus, you cannot exceed 25% of the total student body. So we can't have more than about 250 students here at the school at the same time. So hopefully that should help with the extremely crowded hallways here in Whitney. Now, this was just a brief touch on some of the ideas promoted by the LA Department of Health. I have missed some things, so I would encourage you to take a look at the revised document for more info. Just go to Google and search up the reopening schools protocol for LA. Or you can go down into the description where we'll put a link for the PDF. Thanks for watching.
With that is all that we have for the show, guys, today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember, make sure to stay happy, stay healthy, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.